alchemists were the most trouble. Yes, during the time when we were investigating things through the portal, we reached a time when most of the heavens and dimensions of existence were cleared out and cleaned out, brought here, went through the process of self-forgiveness and self-honesty, and pretty much purifying itself and coming face to face with what it means to be life. And then an interesting thing started to appear through the portal. Suddenly, alchemists in essentially were loners. They were completely internalized loners that has in a way broken contact with everyone else and has developed and practiced the skills of manipulating reality. And their ego was so inflated that they would believe that they are the ultimate answer and that everyone should dance to their demands. And when they would come through, they would take over the heavens and the dimensions, all dimensions of reality, and enslave the whole lot and impose their way on everything. I then simply breathed and continued the discussion from the perspective of what is best for all, and obviously asking the dear alchemist how their proposed dictatorship would bring about what is best for all. You see, with what is best for all, no dictatorship is ever possible. Those that try and impose and say that I am for dictatorship, they're the ones that's actually the dictators. They're the alchemists. They're the haters. They hate everything else because it is not automatically noticing the grand nature of them. And because nobody is at their feet bowing down and saying, oh dear great alchemist, oh great divine one, and you have done so great, you're such a powerful being, you are the ultimate answer, because nobody is at their feet doing that. They are very destructive and angry and revengeful, or vengeful. So inevitably, the discussion would continue in terms of the being, the alchemist's proposed outcomes, and the, you know, in comparing it with the outcome that is best for all. I mean, it's simpler. There is no ways that anything can be better than what is best for all within the context of reality as it exists now. Nobody wants to be a slave. Everyone wants to be able to express themselves freely. Obviously, free choice does do not include abuse. So if you include abuse in your idea of free choice, then obviously you are not standing for free choice. Or if you abuse while you claim that you are standing for free choice, you are not actually standing for free choice. You are in fact trying to limit free choice by utilizing your abusive mental disorders to try and get others to be your slaves, which is exactly what the alchemists were doing. So inevitably, the alchemist realized and was brought to the realization, I mean, you can't stand against what is best for all. There is just no way. So they were brought to realization and then would start their process one and equal as everyone else at the beginning. Let me start at the very first point of self-realization, which is the process of self-forgiveness. And only once self-forgiveness is completed in all its facets and has brought forth the clear realization of self-honesty, would a being actually be able to completely transcend their ego and become one and equal as the group that is best for all, and realize for the first time what love really means, actually, and realize what is going on in reality and how they've contributed to the fuckness of reality as it exists now. So, these alchemists were also the most insisting, very much like your white lighters these days. They all want to be alchemists. They simply don't have a clue what it all means, and they're extremely inflated about their claims and their ideas. They have no cross-referencing. They don't check anything. So, fascinating stuff. Alchemists, it is important. If you really are who you claim to be, you will have no problem to walk as the humblest, simplest point in existence. That's what I do. I don't see, I don't hear, I have brought myself to the lowest, the simplest, the most basic point within existence. I walk breath by breath without any knowledge, without any memory, without any point of the past or the future to support me. I must, in every single breath, direct myself, be part of it all in such a way that it clearly stands as what is best for all, and that it clearly shows my understanding of it in every way. It is my personal test, in a way. It is the ultimate test to walk through existence without any of anything you have ever learned. And you'll be surprised at how many or how amazing ways you find to get through it all. That's how we got to equal money. Equal money was not part of the process. It is born directly out of breath. So when I do an interview on equal money, and I mean, I did 50 now the other day, Maya was here. When I do the interviews on the FAQs for equal money, she asked the question, I do the interview immediately. There is no preparation, there is no thinking, there is no past. It's an immediate expression of understanding of what it is, which proves it's living reality. That is where each one will get to in your process. But understand the process. You start with self-forgiveness. Within that, you start to realize self-honesty. Within that, you start to realize yourself. And eventually, you become the one thing that very few humans has ever achieved. You become self-aware here as breath. But you don't need the mind, but you can use it. It is not about bending the chemicals of reality to your will. That's dictatorship. It is about every part being one and equal as yourself, working together as one, as equals, to bring about what is best for all. That is the process we're busy with. And every part of substance, every part of existence, every chemical, every breath, every drop of sunshine is busy with this process. And it is difficult because each part is, in a way, a personality just like you that must overcome their own accepted and allowed definitions, and must go into agreement with each other to stand for what is best for all in every way. That will take a while, but it is inevitable because it is the only answer, the only way we can create a reality where everyone truly will be happy, because you will no longer have a threat or a point that will terrorize you or drive you to fear. You will be truly free, and all and everything will be equally free as yourself. So you can see the vision of destiny is beyond anything that has ever been presented on earth. It includes everything. The human is the smallest part of it. Just imagine the inflation of the human ego at this stage. You don't even see reality at all. If you understand what I'm saying, and you can grasp what I'm saying, we have support in place, we have the forums in place, we have training in place, we have a system of buddies in place where people that has already proven the points to themselves support you through the process of self-forgiveness and self-honesty. You're not alone within it, yet you are alone within the context that you have to be measurable, self-honest in every breath. And there you have to see for yourself and understand how it functions. And it cannot be in conflict with what is best for all, because then it is ego, and that conflict is an inflation of your idea of reality, which is exclusive. It excludes all other forms of life, and most of that is invisible. You have very limited frequency bands within which you exist. Most of existence that is here, walking process, is invisible. Invisible to the psychics as well, because psychics are only seeing with the mind, and the mind is a limited tool in the context of the universe. Don't be fooled by fools. Fools are those that have faith in their own inflation. And you'll see it in them not questioning and bringing forth a new reality within the physical that is best for all. That is the ultimate test. Can you, as a being, bring about a reality that functions practically in the physical, and that brings forth what is best for all, like what we do at Destiny? And we do this out of breath, not out of planning. We simply express. Those that are now doing their equal money frequent ask questions. They listen to an interview and then immediately do it in their own mother tongue. Support them. I mean, that is an amazing feat to do. That is an amazing accomplish to get to a point of self-trust, where you can look at a point that is new and you can embrace it as yourself, and then you can present it as yourself, one and equal. That is oneness and equality in action. Join us. I dare you.